So hello, everybody, and this is our April webinar, our monthly momentum. And on this particular webinar, we are going to be talking about best ways to work from home. And we have one of our Double Diamond experts, Adam Gilma, who's on the webinar with us today. Hello, Adam.
Hey, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending what time you're viewing this. Hope you're staying well and safe.
And we also have our Chief Development Officer, Dennis Windsor. Dennis.
Hey, everybody, here we go.
So we host all of our Momentum webinars, and these are for you to share with your team. And for those of you that have the ability to take the webinar and maybe translate it for your team, we only do one of these a month. So if you think the information is valuable, then please go ahead and translate this for your team. So for the month of April, there are some really important sales drivers. And when I say sales drivers, these are what can motivate your entire team. And it's global. And really, do we do these globally? So take advantage of our $1 starter kits. That means with any package that you purchase, as you go to the checkout, the kit, instead of whatever price it is you pay in your country, it will be $1. And the other thing that is really exciting and amazing that Janessa has done for the month of April is you can become a founder. And we do not do this very often. We do this when new countries open. And then once a year, around November, if we have spaces, we also offer the Founders Package. So for the month of April, anybody that purchases Ambassador Pack will become a founder, or if they do an upgrade to Ambassador Pack, you will become a founder. And you can get with your local region or customer service or your upline diamond for training on how the Founders Package works, so that you can participate in the next quarter. So if you become a founder in April, then you can participate in the next one. You can't participate in the existing quarter of April, but you will be all set and ready for the next quarter. And this is going to be the only time that you will be able to become a founder before that next quarter. So you can also check out your local and regional promotions. And if you're not getting these in your email, then what I suggest you do is you log into your back office and you see this little icon right in front of you there, that little envelope, which is there under your tools. That is where we will send all the mail, and you'll be able to find it in the language that goes with however you signed up. This is one of the slides from Scott Lewis's Exec Connect. So you can go back and you can review the Exec Connect as well. And again, he's announcing the worldwide starter kits that went from the 23rd of March all the way through to the end of April. So what an exciting time. And if you can do this on top of participating in whatever local, regional cash promotion, you are gonna have an amazing April. And you're gonna do all of this from working at home, which brings on our very next guest. So Adam, first of all, how are you and your family doing through all of this huge change to the way we do our business?
Well, it's been a change. Of course, we have AJ, our 7-year-old at home, and this homeschooling, and our little one, Alexa, she's only a year and 8 months, but she's rambunctious anyway. But what I'm finding is that even the schools, maybe not all the schools, but where AJ goes, they're using video conferencing as a way to communicate. In fact, I see AJ with his music teacher. I see AJ with his grammar and his reading instructor going over this stuff with him as he's on his on a phone, on one of our phones, and or on the computer. And that's it. I know people are working from home. And so with the changes that are taking place in society, I saw India just locked down. India. I got a message from Russia. Russia's on a complete lockdown. So the only way for us to be social creatures is doing exactly what we're doing right now. And we're coming to you from my home here in San Juan Capistrano, California. And I'm sure that this message is being reviewed and seen with Lucy and Dennis all over the world, from people in their own home on their phone or on a computer. And this is how we're doing it now. In fact, I'm not traveling that much, but I feel like I've been traveling, because just the other day, I made record 23 Zoom calls in a day. And it's exciting, Lucy. It's exciting times.
I think all of you that are road warriors, and when we say that, you, when in normal days, are on a plane all the time, and you're traveling to meetings, and you could also travel locally where you live in California too. you guys have taken all of that energy that you put into your travel and you put it into Zoom webinars. It's pretty impressive. I know that you and Alex and the rest of your, Serge and Eric and the rest of your team and Barbara, right. And I've seen your webinars. So from, you know, I know from the point of view from the company, from Wendy and Scott and Randy, they're very, very thankful that you leaders have all stepped up. And 23 webinars in one day, I think you're setting records just hearing about that.
Well, last year we did over 400 and something thousand miles. And this is easier, but I will tell you, you become far more available to people because, you know, you're not going through security lines or you're not on an airplane. But I just want to talk about, you know, people always ask one of the best ways to work from home. Like, obviously, you need a phone. I mean, today, you know, we're not using flip phones anymore. We've got nice touchscreen phones. And I mean, they're as powerful as a computer, Lucy. So what it is, you know, I can send a text, I can do WhatsApp. I can also make things work on a Zoom call, right? I can also get an email sent and also, you know, get news alerts, right? Popping in, actually there's one that's coming in right now, right over the
phone. I know, it's like squirrel.
as we're talking.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. I mean, and then the other thing is almost everybody has a laptop, right? So that's completely possible. I've got a laptop here on my desk. I would use that too. You know, I've had to switch because some of the phone doesn't last power-wise when you're using it as much as we are now on Zoom or video conference calls. So I had to switch over to sometimes using the laptop to make that work. But, you know, the biggest thing is like staying connected. Like I've reached out to a whole bunch of people that are locked down in their own home, right, under lockdown. And I'm like, okay, listen, let's make the best of it. Like, because, you know, you need to have a vision. 90 days from now, maybe a little more, whatever the case is. Another call coming in, excuse me. we're going to be out of this crazy situation that the world is in. And if you take a look at some of the news and what's happened in, you know, where this thing started, they're kind of out of it. In fact, I just heard recently that China Seaport has opened up for exports and what have you. Hong Kong will be opening up soon. And it's kind of like, you know, going through the rest of the world. So, you know, you got to plan something for like the next maybe 10 weeks, 11 weeks, 12 weeks and get serious. And then the other challenge that I found myself having working from home was because there were so many Zoom links from all the teams sending, I was like, oh my gosh, I gotta schedule these things properly. So I use an iPhone, you know, I'm sure you use whatever you're using on your Samsung or what have you, but I schedule everything out into my calendar, my digital calendar, and then I put a 15 minute reminder up there. And like during a Zoom call, if one's back to back, those schedules keep popping up, which is great. So I'll go from one to the other. And then for translation, because sometimes, you know, we're speaking Russian, or when I'm not speaking Russian, I'm speaking in English, but it's in a different language. And it's really great because what you can do is you can actually socialize and have a good conversation. But, you know, you want to stay busy. You want to stay busy and productive on these calls. And what that means is you want to be precise. Like the other day, we talked about the Founders Program, right? And we know it's limited time. And here in the month of April, what you want to be able to do is get yourself ready for July and make sure that you get that program. I messaged Scott, myself, and Wendy on a text message, and I said, fantastic promotion. And what we're finding is a lot of people are stepping up and upgrading and becoming founders. Mm-hmm. And I tell people, like, they want to know, we did a founders call, how the founders program works. Then we did, how the compensation structure works, how the six ways to get paid. Then I had people asking about like the diamond pool and the travel reward program. And we've catered on these scheduled calls, different topics and things to make sure that we can communicate to the teams what we're doing so we can stay very, very effective. And then the other thing is that sometimes you gotta reach out to maybe some team members you haven't talked to in a while. And this is the perfect time to actually go out and reach out to somebody because, you know, normally you're traveling, you're busy, and sometimes you forget, you think about, man, I should contact that person, send them a text. Hey, listen, I'm doing a Zoom, come on, let's talk. And just maybe it's not a scheduled call for your team, but maybe you're just like doing what we did earlier, Lucy. We connected on like a FaceTime call or whatever, right. It is, yeah. You know, and that's
well, that was
that's
working the at the time, right?
yeah, but like that's the connectivity. And then because we can't go outside and we can't be super social, You know, I am still working out every day, just so everybody knows. I'm up in the morning. I did 5 miles this morning on a walk, hike. I do some workout here at the house. We've got a small little gym here, nothing massive, but, you know, so I'm staying active. I'm staying on my daily routine. And what I'm finding is that it gives me tons of energy. I actually tracked on my iWatch how many hours I was up working. And one day it was that day I did all those webinars, Zoom calls, I was actually up for 21 hours. So, you know, I'm not saying that you have to be super duper like that. And, you know, I mean, we'd love it. But the point is that I had a lot of stuff to catch up with, a lot of people to connect with. We had a big, huge team globally. And what we've been doing on these Zooms is we're getting on an average of, let's say, 400. And then some of them are over 1,000. We can't fit everybody on them. So we do another one to actually fit the groups and make everybody come together and work.
I have to throw a question out for you that actually we didn't pre-vet this question. But what do you think the industry is going to learn from all of this time that people are staying home and working from home?
That's a great question. I think we're back to basics. Actually, that was one of the calls I had with Wendy. It was funny. We were talking. I'm like, man, this is back in old day direct selling network marketing because we didn't have Zoom. And we had phones and you had to know a three-way calling, but it wasn't exactly as technical as it is today. So it's back to the basics, right? And I think that's one of the key things that, you know, a lot of people maybe miss about our industry. It's great to have a big sales organization, but, you know, what you got to do is you got to get back into that first gear. And that first gear, Lucy, is contacting people, staying in touch. I have a term for it in our training. We call it keeping the soup warm. Nobody likes cold soup. So if you keep it warm and you're kind of touching, you know, every now and then and what have you, reaching out, letting somebody know you're thinking about them. I think that's going to be fantastic for our industry. And I think coming, not only are we seeing sales volume move in the right direction and, you know, even corporate take a much, much proactive role in connecting. I heard on Exec Connect last month, Scott Lewis reached out and said, listen, if you're, you know, Diamonds, reach out to me. I want to come on your Zoom calls. And we did. We reached out to Scott right away, got him on a Zoom call the very next day, and we had a packed out call. And what this is showing the caring of the act, not from just the company, but what we're doing in the current crisis that we're under. I think it's going to be fantastic. And people are going to learn that they can actually build a business from the comfort of their own home and participate in the three greatest industries, home-based business ownership, smart internet technology that we're doing right now, and of course, our incredible, amazing Jeunesse products that help with anti-aging.
That's so right. And I think that people probably are going to come out of this probably with more training and better training and more accurate, because instead of you being with just one group in one of your countries, you're constantly pretty much with all your teams, as many as you can possibly get on a call. So, you know, rather than in, you know, single language, you're now doing multi-focus at a time. So I'm very excited about that. And you know, I don't want to hear from anybody anymore that they don't have enough training. They can get on a Zoom.
there's plenty of training.
Not being there.
You know, what else are we going to do? Like, you know, I mean, you turn on the news and it's like the news in every country is like, it's basically the same stuff, right? Okay. Maybe it's in a different language. And, you know, our hearts go out to the people that are, you know, getting this virus, and it's obviously having a detriment on their health. But staying connected is very, very important. And then the other thing is you know, utilizing social media. Facebook is great. I mean, you know, you can post your stuff there. I use Facebook as a great way in order to update. I haven't posted a lot lately, like I would be traveling on a plane or whatever the case is. But I use my social media for, it's a way to speak to a huge audience. And sometimes it's good to shoot a video. Hey, here's what's going on. Here's what you're finding. What's happening with you with this coronavirus and how your schedule's changed and things like that. But, you know, it's also a very good way for everybody to see what you're doing. And the other day, we posted a nice picture of, like, all these people on a Zoom call. Didn't post the video of it, which is, you know, another way to do it. So people get the message right away. And I was like, man, all these people, all these home-based business entrepreneurs looking for ways to drive additional income working from home. And as you know, in not only here in the United States, but, you know, globally, people can't work. And this is an incredible opportunity. So you know, with the Facebook posting, what it led to is people saying, what are you doing? How do you make money from home? And that's key to getting either more customers coming into the business and or, of course, new distributors that want to go in and be customer acquirers and have them get into the business. And here's the great thing. They're coming in learning right away. Like, you can do this live on a Zoom call or a some video technology and actually do the business. So I love that stuff.
Yeah. So social media, I think everything that you've said is so pertinent to what people need to do right now. And I'm sure they're hearing it from all over the place, but not only are you sharing this with them, you're doing it yourself and you're live. So just to wrap up, and I can't tell you how much I appreciate you taking the time out of your very busy day with 23 Zoom and sharing this and taking this information and sharing it with the entire world, which is beyond your team. It's all the other teams together. So just to wrap up this part, you know, what is the few words of wisdom that you'd like to share with the field?
Okay, so for me, I've had this ritual successful habitude that I get into where I have a daily mode of operation. You know, I have a way of working my plan every single day. So like every morning I get up at around 6:30, 7 a.m. I get into my workout stuff. Usually if it's a school day, I'm taking kids to school. That's not happening right now. So it's giving me a little bit of time to get my workouts done earlier than what I normally would. And then I lay out the plan. And what I'm always planning my, you know, I'm always planning my my work, right? I think you can see that on the screen. But I'm always planning out my work. And the reason I'm doing that is I'm planning. I'm putting in notes. Hey, Adam, you did this Zoom. I don't just make a digital version of it. I put it down in writing. And I have a plan. I have a daily journal. I have things that keep me on track to make sure that I can keep up with what's happening with the organization around the world. But I have a work ethic. And that's the other thing is like, you got to be strict on yourself working from home. I know various other professionals that I connected with that go to an office every day. Okay. That's their work environment. So they're away from the children. They're away from maybe a wife, significant other, family. And now they have to submerge themselves into, like, you know, kids running around the house with things going on. So you got to be strict. And then the other thing is, I think setting boundaries and guidelines. Hey, you know, daddy has to work. I have to do this, and this, but hey, we can go and play outside in the backyard later. These are things that I think if people set boundaries on so they can do their business and be specific and focused on it, and then also be able to transition and have incredible family time and, you know, good time with loved ones. Trying to mix it all together sometimes can be difficult if you've got children running in the middle of a Zoom or, you know, and I'm used to it. I've had it happen many times. You just got to get used to it. But, you know, if you're new, these are just some of the things you just have to be flexible with and understand that this too will pass. You know, the sky isn't falling. 90 days, 120 days from now, you can look up and look back and go, wow, look at what we've taught the base, your foundation of new business builders to come on board and do. Connect with Zoom. And then, of course, when we do startup travel, I think people are going to want to be extremely social. I think the events are just going to be more packed than ever before when we do start to travel because, you know, this is a social business. And I think people will want to be around and tell them their experiences. But I think the work ethic that's being developed now over the last, you know, March, April, May, June of doing, staying home, working, you know, abiding by some of the rules that the governments have set up for us so we can stay healthy. I think all this is very, very important, but we can take advantage of it. And that's the message I want to get out to anybody right now watching is take advantage of this because I think after this passes, you know, as life kind of returns to a norm, some of the work ethic will go with that and we won't have the same circumstances. So make the best of what we have happening right now and stay healthy. Do your part to keep this world a better place. Thanks, Lucy.
I really, really appreciate you being with us. Thank you so much, Adam. So that you've heard it from Adam Gilmer and how important it is to treat your business as a business, to schedule time with your family members. And, you know, it's kind of nice when you're working at home because you can actually weave that throughout your day. Like I can have lunch with my husband every day, which never happens in a normal world. And you divide up part of your house. Like I'm working in one of the guest bedrooms and he's got the study. And I know that the team that I'm talking to in the morning time, they've divvied up, you know, like the kids have their space. So however it is making it work, it's just, we're all very human about this right now. And we're very blessed that we have a business that we can just keep going like without we even missed a beat. So with that, I'd like to wrap up the momentum call with our Chief Development Officer, Dennis Winza. And Dennis, you always have great advice on, you know, what the people can do right now with everything that's going on. So welcome back to the momentum call. And we're excited to hear what words you're going to share with us today.
Awesome. Thank you. That's too kind of you. And I love hearing Adam. I've heard him around the globe. I think in like maybe 15 different countries, at least I've heard him on stage. And the passion is like he does do it, but I know all of our other diamonds do it. His team members do it. So does everybody else. They set the pace, right? It's all about leading from the front at these times. And Lucy, what I want to kind of talk about for a few moments, I think the mindset, maybe to let the people just experience from what I've experienced, not to say my age or anything that I just turned 60, but I've been in the industry since 1980, which is crazy to think about, right? That's, I mean, I think that for sure you are walking around maybe with just barely on one foot, maybe walking around. But anyway, it's been a long time. And yeah, there's waves that happened during that four decades, right? That you look back and you go, oh my gosh, this was a time that I capitalized. And my upline, my leaders, they told me what to do. And I actually went out and did it. And it went crazy, it went ballistic. And I firmly believe, it's crazy to say this, but I really think this moment is the ultimate time ever we've ever had to share Jeunesse. Because if the world right now is listening. That's one thing that what we do when we share. You know, one thing I share occasionally, I kid around, Lucy, is to share Jeunesse, all you have to do is blah, 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 right? You just share about the company, share about the product, and just have energy, love, respect, honesty, but share and share and share and share. And right now is the ultimate time because we have a worldwide audience. Like Adam had said, virtually everybody is available to talk right now, which is insane. If you think about network marketing, is really almost does come down to simple math. Like I got X amount of hours that I could put a week into it, and I can try to get some other people on my team, and then they have X amount of hours that maybe they can put their team into it. And then during those times, they're calling their friends and their contacts, but they can't get a hold of them. And they get so many excuses. Oh, I got to take my kids to a soccer game. Oh, we got plans tomorrow night. Oh, my husband and I were traveling. Right now, there's no excuses. Everybody is available. Like you can call anybody and they can say, hey, what's up? I'm glad to get on a call with you. Please, invite, can I invite my friends with it, right? So now is this incredible moment in time. I guarantee you, we will never have this again, I think, in our lifetimes when everybody is available to talk. And then what we do is we leverage that right this moment. There's some nuggets from my perspective. I have spent like half my career building big organizations and recruiting, you know, hundreds, and I've recruited a lot of people during decades for sure. And I love that. I love that new person that wants to come into the business. So the awareness and sense of urgency is like incredible right now for the listener, right? They are aware that they may need additional X. I'm going to share what those are in just a minute. But what this awareness and urgency does, it creates expedited decisions from your contacts and your people. So if you have the energy and like Adam said, the discipline, and you write it down and you do the actions like your upline leaders are telling you to do to bring new people in, you will get expedited decisions right at this moment for people to join as a customer or a distributor. Look at our space. I mean, we're not selling things that people don't want to buy right now. We actually, as a company, our focus is how do we make the world just have healthier lives and great lives? Adam talked about it. Of course, you got to exercise. Of course, you got to be disciplined. Don't order a whole bunch of takeout pizza right now and sit at home and eat pizza all day long. No, stay disciplined. Keep exercising. We're allowed to get out, do that social distancing thing for sure. But exercise is maybe more than you have for a long time. Right now you can exercise 7 days a week if you want. Just get out there, take the Jeunesse products. The new customers, new distributors, that's what we're offering them is additional great products that can enhance their life. And they know they need that more than ever right now. Secondly, look at this. If the world is not aware that they need a second stream of income, like right now, it's the most glaring news, right, in the entire 40 years I've been around that you need a second income. Like Blair, and all you got to do is blah, 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 follow up with all of our e-commerce platform. And Lucy, just go to that next slide. I've got a few nuggets I'll close with. But those two things right there, we have the system, we have the product, and for sure we have the opportunity. I'd say number one, keep it so simple. For me, if I was trying to build a team, I would stay so focused right now on team expansion. Obviously, you want to train and you want to lead, you want to grow as a person, all those other things. But number one is enroll as many new customers and distributors you can right now to help them. You're not just trying to help yourself. If you focus in on those people's needs and you're honest with integrity and passion and great tools that we have with Jeunesse, we have all these tools, right? Adam just talked about, you know, I remember when phones, back in some of my days when I did all that recruiting, well, there was a phone actually attached to a wall. And that was old school for sure. You could only go like 10 feet away. And then I remember they invented this thing called a headset with a battery, and you could walk around the room, right? And you could make phone calls. And then they had the ability to do a three-way. What the heck? We leveraged that like crazy. But look where you are right now. Digital at your fingertips. Everybody's got a phone in their pocket or in their hand probably 18 hours a day, right? That you can do, and everybody in your upline, your mentors, your leaders, your diamonds, they're available for three ways. Just think, if you're a distributor and you've wanted to get some of your upline on a three way, but everybody's crazy busy. Like, just think, Adam, traveling around the world, it's hard to catch because of time zones, all that. Look at your upline. They're all at home right this minute. So you can grab them as an expert on these three-way calls, and you don't have to do all the presentation. Let those tools, Mark Patterson, the marketing team at our company, look, sharejeunesse.com has a plethora of every single kind of tool that will do the blah, 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 blah for you. All you have to do is love them, have energy, and ask them to get involved. Zoom meetings, oh my gosh, what great technology right now. And then social media, Adam's already hit on that, but for sure, share Jeunesse with anybody you know. And here's a big thing, you know, Lucy, we've been going around the world talking about that 2020 is definitely going to be a limitless year that's going to become a limitless decade. That's still what's going to happen. We're going to get through this time. This is going to be a bump, and it may be a big bump, but we're going to get through it. So for sure, make sure you try to get everybody with you to expand their comfort zones and get out of their comfort zone. So on your list, when you've got all those people that you think are untouchable, that wouldn't ever consider Jeunesse, use these tools like Adam talked about. Use these tools to go after what you would consider the hardest, toughest people to ever get into business. Third thing, and I'll just close with this, of course, I learned it a long time ago. A friend of mine, he's a public speaker, 25 years ago told me, and doing things, you got to ask. And he said, don't just ask, but ask and ask and ask and ask. So during this time, share everything about Jeunesse, have your upline help collaborate that, and then just simply ask, hey, I would love to help you right now. I'd love to have you part of this great family. And I'm going to ask you right now, we've got a great company, and here's a couple options for you. You know, if you'd like to start on some basic products, I'd recommend A or B. Would that work for you? Or if you want to, you know, join the team and be part of this global movement, how about starting with one of these packs that fits your budget, fits your needs? And I'm just going to ask you right now, why don't we do that today? Let's get started today, and then let me help you leverage what we're doing for this time period for you. So ask them all to get involved right now. So those are my thoughts, the basic thoughts. Love this message of the entire focus of this monthly momentum, Lucy. Great job. So thank you for letting me be on.
Oh, thank you so much. And I think you've heard from our chief development officer, not only has he experience in the field as well, but, you know, just reinforcing everything that Adam Gilmer said as well, how important it is to stay connected. And that was Scott Lewis's message as well. So from all of us at Global Headquarters, we'd like you to stay connected, stay safe. And I think one of the things I'm so impressed is just seeing people loving on each other. You know, people supporting each other, they're understanding we are all, for the first time around the world, in the same boat. So this is a great time to reach out, even if it's just to listen to someone and be empathetic with them and know that they're not alone, that they're part of a great big team. And this is where we are, one team, one family, one Jeunesse. So we'll see you on the next monthly Momentum. And I hope that you share this with your entire team. Thank you so much.
Go get them, everybody. See you around the world.